G'day beautiful people, I'm Biotek Rocky, and we're back with Firewatch. This is episode 2, and last time I think we saw two naked chicks skinny dipping by the lake. They were shooting off fireworks, and unfortunately I couldn't get any action. Disappointing. Anyhow, I'm stuck out in the woods. By myself, because there was some epic story that you can see you can watch the previous video. I'll leave the link below. And at the end of last episode, I had my watch station, whatever you want to call it, broken into, and they looted it, and it's now just been cleaned up. Now Actually, I'm not sure what we're doing. I don't know. Don't know. Oh, let's get into it. Let's see. He was typing up a story or something before. Can we pick up the whiskey? Okay. Save for later. Okay. I don't know where you put that. Bundle of fireworks. Sweet. That's the fireworks I confiscated off the chicks. Forrest Burns. He's now gonna be my bodyguard for my watchtower, so nobody else breaks in. Well, can't repair the window. And obviously I don't need... Oh, okay. He does grab his bag. Wonder where I go. Where do I have to go? Let's see if Delilah... Nope. Delilah, what are you doing? You getting drunk and sleeping again? Now where's that baseball? Here we go. You're coming with me, baseball. Actually, I'm gonna name you Wilson. Since, it's got a very castaway sort of feeling. Wilson the baseball. Oh, where'd my shitter go? I'm sure my shitter was out here. Oh, there it is. It's okay. Don't panic. I guess. I'm out in the woods. There's a man shit in the woods. If he doesn't have an outhouse. Actually, like the outhouse. It's still gross. I feel like I'm gonna be murdered when I'm in there.
I feel like I'm gonna be murdered when I'm in the outhouse.
Feeling a little exposed, are we?
Hey, no man in the history of the world has felt tough with his pants around his ankles.
Be strong. You can always call if you're having trouble.
Sure, I'll do that.
Okay, Delilah's a bit weird, in my opinion. She's very, I think been out here a bit long, a bit loopy. But I guess if she doesn't have somebody like Wilson, say hello, Wilson. Hey, guys. Okay, so I don't know where we're going. Where are we going? Oh, I can't. Hang on. Just sit there for a second, Wilson. We need to work out where we're going. Oh, that's right. I remember something about the communication lines are down or something. And it was near where the cave was. So, which is just there near that cache 303. See cave 452? That's where we gotta go. Now, you gotta help me, because I'm pretty terrible at navigating. So, north. This way. Let's go, Wilson. You be my protection from any, like, bears or mystery people in the woods. Okay, sure. Wilson, you sound a lot like me. I don't know what you're talking about. Bear tooth point. Oh. That doesn't sound good, because usually names are named after something. Am I gone, North? No, Wilson. Wilson, sit. Okay, I'm on the right path. Oh, Wilson! Wilson, don't run away! Fuck you, Wilson. Really? Really? Damn it. Oh, shit. That's a bit hectic. Man, I just did that jumping. I'm fucking Spider-Man. Okay, so... Do you like how I turn my head around, I lean my head when I need to look around the corner? I notice I'm... What'd that say? Come back. Alright.
Ah, it's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold in Boulder, though, right?
Yeah, they are.
What did you get up to down there? I mean, what's life like?
I just spend a lot of time with Julia.
Oh, so you have someone there.
Well...
But you're taking a little break, or...
We're...
Look, I'm sorry. Can you hold that thought?
Sure. I'm just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you? Okay, good.
What?
No, I don't think he has any idea.
Hey, your button is still down.
I'm absolutely sure. Would you? Alright, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard.
What's going on?
Hey, sorry about that. Anyway, Julia, girlfriend? Ex? Sorry, I don't mean to pry.
Who was that?
Who was who?
I don't think he has any idea. What was that? Were you talking about me?
What?
You left your button pressed or something.
Henry, that call was work. I was just talking to... Actually, it's not really your business. Why are you freaking out?
I'm not freaking out.
Good. I'm gonna go quiet for a little bit. Call me if it's important.
Deli stepped away. She's annoyed. Oh, fuck you, Deli. Wilson, don't you run away again. I need to find out where I'm going. So I'm close to the cave. I just gotta keep going. Wilson, where are you going? Oh. Here's the cave. Here's the cave, hooray! Ooh. Wilson? I don't like dark places. Will you hold my hand? Sure thing. I don't see any communication lines here. That's because you're not looking hard enough. Well, fuck you, Wilson. I don't see you helping. That's because you just... I'm coming along for the ride. This is your job. Who asked you? Who brought you along? So, do you even know if we got on the right way? Well, how am I supposed to know? You're the one carrying me. I'm just a ball. Well, fuck you. Gap in brush. Just shut up and sit down. I need to... There. Oh, Wilson! Where the fuck were you going, Wilson? I'm trying to get away from your dumb ass. What? Don't call me dumb. I happen to be very intellectual. Yeah, well, that's what you think. You're the one talking to a boy. Yeah, you got me there. I'm lonely, alright? Don't be a bitch. Man up. So, I wonder, where are we going? Where are we going, Wilson? Where's this communication line? You're asking me dumb questions again. I don't even know what a communication line is. Oh, here we go. I see a power pipe. See that? See that? Right there. You see it? That's power. Oh, that's electricity goes through that, okay? And you say you're intellectual. Well, you know what? Fuck you. Oh, this hill is so steep. Bitching again. Yeah, alright. I'll take my skirt off, okay?
I can see the wire you're talking about. It looks like it's in good shape from here.
We'll follow it up to the top of the trail if you can. You can head back as soon as you give me the all clear.
Got it.
Do you think Dali sounds hot? Well, I do, actually. She does have a pretty sexy voice. Although she sounds like a bit of a crackpot. But when you're alone in the woods, anything sounds hot. Yeah, true point. Don't ask me a dumb question. Sorry. What's this over here? You did it again. Okay. I'm still... Is this another shooter? Why, yes it is. Thanks for asking. I'm full of wisdom. Fuck you, Wilson.
Hey, I found a structure that might have been an outhouse once, I think.
Whoa, you don't need my permission to go to the bathroom, but, you know, use abandoned shitters at your own peril.
I mean, I'm in the right area?
I do believe. The comms wire runs for quite a ways. Follow it all the way to the top of Beartooth Point, and if it's not damaged, you can loop around back home.
Anyhow. So, would you do her? What do you mean, would I do her? On a ball? Well, hypothetically, would you do her if you had the chance? Maybe if she was the last woman on Earth. What do you mean if she was the last woman on Earth? You mean you'd pick, like, other people over Delhi? Yeah. Okay, good call. I guess we are out in the middle of the woods, alone. And no, I'm not going to help you with hand jobs. Really? Really? You had to go there. What was that? I don't know. Why don't you go check it out? Is it safe? Wilson? Wilson? Are you just trying to get away? Fuck you, Wilson. You're not a very good friend. Fuck you too. I love you. I love you too, Wilson. Well, I think we need to get up there. What was that? What was that? Something I can report into Delhi. Nothing. Fine. I can still hear that sound. Can you hear that sound, Wilson? I haven't got any ears, dumbass. Well... These are the beer cans that those girls were drinking. Girls? You saw girls up here and you didn't bring them back to the cabin? No, okay. They were fucking skinny dipping out in the middle of the lake. And? And... Just shut up. I'm gonna report these beer cans.
Hey, so there are beer cans all over the ground up here leading up the hill.
That's annoying.
Yeah, thing is, there were a bunch down at that campsite yesterday.
Coincidence, maybe?
I don't think so. Same brand, everything.
These fucking kids.
How could these girls be so stupid?
Trust me, I never underestimate the stupidity of a drunk teenager. Also, I never underestimate the balls of a drunk young woman, having been one.
Wilson. Go look over there. Ah. Okay, that's not what I was trying to do. There we are. I was trying to be a good boy and clean up. Now, I'm coming back, Wilson. Oh. How'd you like your trip? Fuck you.
Well, I hopped down a drop and now I can't climb back up.
That is a pickle.
I can just keep hiking, but I figured I should let you know in case I get myself trapped out here.
How adventurous of you.
I've been doing a lot more climbing out here than I expected.
Well, keep your radio charged. I'd hate to one day find a skeleton with an orange backpack at the bottom of a ravine.
She sounds like a care factor zero. I agree. We're at the top, Wilson. Check out the view. While I clean up. Clean up this... Wilson. Where the fuck are you going? Look, here's another can. And? Not my problem. Wilson? Yes? Don't be a bitch.
Yeah, okay, the wire's down here.
Okay, good. Any sign of those girls? Did they mess with anything?
I'll look around. Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it. Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
I knew it the moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Hmm. Let's hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I am gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Well, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something. I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
Wilson, I'm starting to like Deli. Me too. She's got a dark side. And that's sexy in a woman. Really? How would you know what women there are out there? Have you played the dating game? More than you know. More than you, actually. Now thinking about it. Wilson, fuck you. You don't know anything about me. I only met just yesterday, and you're being a little bitch. Well, la-di-da. Actually, I can tell what kind of man you are just from meeting you. I'm good at reading people, okay? Really? Well, what kind of man am I? A little bitch that likes to whinge. Yeah, I'm not gonna argue there. I'm out here trying to look for these girls. Well, that's a good start.
I've got an overgrown trail here.
Yeah, that'll happen.
So I'm screwed when it comes to getting past it?
Mm-hmm. Screwed until you clear it yourself, yeah.
Great. Well, if I come across some tools, I'll add groundskeeping to my ever-increasing list of responsibilities.
Wilson, sit. Nope. Make yourself useful. What do you mean, useful? See that? Can you clear it? Fucking dumbass. Wilson, why do I put up with you? Because I'm all you've got. So, Wilson, how did you end up out here? I don't know, some little bitch brought me out here. I used to be in a city with all the kids and the girls, and some little bitch that got dumped decided to come out here and bring me with him. I didn't want to come, but here we are. Now I'm stuck with your fat ass. Well, I love you too. Another long drop. Actually, Wilson, see if it's safe. Is it safe? You're just gonna say yes, I'd do it, and then watch me break my ankle, aren't you? No, I don't believe you. Aha, I didn't break my ankle. Fuck you.
I gotta tell you, all this climbing and jumping, it's pretty invigorating.
Just wait for the rest of the summer when you'll be sitting on your fat ass 14 hours a day.
that makes me think she's fat. Why do you say that? Because she likes to sit around in her fat ass. Really? Well, I don't see much else to do out here. Although... Shut up, Henry. I see your bag. Good call.
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
Wilson, sit. Brian Goodwin. Wilson. Fuck you, Wilson. Are you trying to lie? Yes. I told you to sit. You know what? Fuck you. Sit over there and don't move. Okay, what do we got? Oh, camera? Ah.
Well, I am flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them, in decent condition, too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
What, was he a fella you had a thing with?
Yeah. It was so hot and heavy. Of course, Brian Goodwin was 12 years old, so, you know, our love could never really be understood. I'm kidding. Not about him being an actual 12-year-old. That part's true. He was stationed in Two Forks, near Lookout, with his dad Ned 3 summers ago. Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
Why couldn't handle your charms? Did you keep in touch?
What, they couldn't handle your unique brand of charm?
Not many can.
Unsurprising.
Anyway, so it goes. Have fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photo dome employee.
I don't know, I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
Well, thanks, Deli. Nothing like some company. I've got all the company I can now. I can keep. What the hell? C to use disposable camera. Wilson. Fuck, you're annoying. Take a picture of me. What? Really? Okay, hold still. Say cheese. There. You happy? I can't pick you up, Wilson. Wilson. No. Nah, Wilson. Fuck. Oh, no, Wilson, I have to leave you here. Good. See you later, douchebag. You're gonna be missed. I can't believe that. No. It was fun while it lasted. See you, Wilson. Nice knowing you. Well, I think I'm well and truly lost. And now I've lost Wilson, it's really devoured me. What is it? Supply crash. What? Oh. Note. Oh, hang on. What is it? Cue to read. Dave, guess who's going out with Debbie next week? No, not that shitheel Steve. Yeah, you shitheel. It's your man, Ron. My man, Ron? Fucking cheating bastard. I went up to check out the new guy at Two Forks and heard him talking to himself. More than usual for the Lowe's. L-O's? So I figured I'd stay away. Remember when you saw Chimney Rock having himself that in that hammock? What? I'm starting to think that the Forest Service only picks deranged and perverted. Except for us, of course. We're creme de la creme. Let's toast to Deb at the spot. Ron. Oh, note from Ron. Right. I'm guessing, loose fossilized claw? Really? Wow. Too bad you can't take it with you. Loose stone. Why would this be in here? Like, there's stones fucking everywhere. Oh yeah, that's right. Don't forget to copy down the map. So, where are we? Exactly. Holy shit, we're miles away from Two Forks. R.I.P. Wilson. So, we're heading south. Better close up. Don't want the bears getting into it.
I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards Five Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood. Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Will do.
Right, yeah. Alright, so we got our next destination. I guess I should really check where we're going. It's southwest. Oh, shit. Southwest. Does that mean that we can't go this way? Does that mean we have to go? Maybe we'll go this way. Because I think it might be coming on round from the other side of the rock.
I'm having a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Flapjack?
Excuse me, flapjack?
You know, like a loser, a chotch.
I really don't. but I do now.
Well, the next time you're at a bar and some banker steps on your foot so he can order his crappy martini, you've got just the name to use.
Hey, Flapjack, why don't you wait your turn before I bounce your face off a dumpster?
It's beautiful!
Beautiful. Couldn't have said it better myself.
Hey, Delilah?
What do you got? You found him?
No, not yet. Why would there be a fence out here?
Because sometimes hikers go ass over tea kettle when on a trail.
So the Forest Service would put up a big chain link fence?
A chain link fence?
Yeah, it looks like it surrounds a huge area.
Huh, that's weird.
Quick.
Who are they keeping out of here? And why?
Jeez, I don't know. Maybe it's...
almost missed it.
...biologists, you know? Well, they don't want people traipsing on their precious lichens.
What's a lichen?
What's a lichen?
Wouldn't you lichen to know?
Oh my god, goodbye.
I'll ask next time I talk to someone, but that'll probably Cheesy be a few days.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I have to go. What is this? Nope. Can't.
Do you think those girls could be behind this fence?
Well, having once been an ornery young woman, the last thing I would do is climb a fence. Especially if I knew I was in trouble.
I don't even know how I would get in.
It's really strange that that's out there, by the way.
Yeah, it's weird.
Well, looking at that sign on the fence, I think it's put there by the government, so... I don't know. Maybe you shouldn't fuck with it? Maybe it's Roswell. It's another Roswell.
Hey. Sorry about snapping at you earlier. I thought about it, and... yeah, I suppose that must have sounded kind of weird when you heard me take that other call. Plus, you're just out here in your own head. Trust me, I know how it is. So... did you break any hearts back in Colorado when you took this job? I myself have chosen to never get attached to anyone who would miss me, but... I know I'm a bit of an outlier. I don't... I mean that the way it sounds. I mean, I care about people, and I like companionship as much as the next person. But why does it have to come from the same person for your whole life? My Aunt Kathy was married to the same guy for 4 decades, and when he died, she found out he'd been having an affair with a real estate broker for 15 years. Whereas my Aunt Judy traveled the world dating artists and musicians as she saw fit. Call me crazy, but I'd rather spend a week in bed with Sonny Bono than half a lifetime with some cheating stockbroker.
I'm actually married.
But you're here.
Everything's fine. Just, you know, we're taking some time apart, getting some fresh air.
A little change.
Yeah.
All right. Well, we can just leave it at that.
Thanks.
Yeah. I thought I'd be honest. Use it means you can... oh, Delilah's town. Okay. Okay. Fair enough. There's... obviously, you can't call it in. So, where's that thin plume of smoke again? I'm a bit lost. Maybe. Do you hear that? I might start running.
I take it you fell prey to the Forest Service's big recruiting effort when it comes to, you know, how the hell you ended up out here.
I saw the job in the paper and figured, you know, what the heck?
What the heck? I've got no ties and no life. Better go spend what's left of it in utter loneliness.
Something like that?
Yeah, thanks to last summer, the bump in Forest Service budget actually allowed for us to advertise for the job. Glad it worked.
What happened last summer that accounted for this, windfall?
Jeez. I mean, the federal government almost let Yellowstone National Park burn to the ground? Ring a bell?
Yellowstone is, like, what, 15 miles away? Why would they do that?
Well, the short story is that for 60 years, we got very good at not letting forest fires happen. And then about 15 years ago, they decided that forest fires in wilderness areas like Yellowstone should be left to burn. So that's what they did. I can't believe you didn't hear about this. There were reports that the entire park was gone. Dan Rather telling the country that President Reagan didn't care on the nightly news. I mean, what the hell's he gonna do? Smoke jump in and snuff one out for the Gipper?
She likes to talk a lot.
So what should they have done?
I don't even know. By the time the Yellowstone folks realized the little fires weren't going to burn themselves out, 100,000 acres were gone. It's Yellowstone, you know? People don't want to touch it. But we touch it every single day. But hey, I got a 30 cents an hour raise because we can't have another fiasco. Like the goddamn park can burn down again.
Wow. I'm on top of a natural bridge out here.
Really? Is it a complete arch?
No, I guess the bridge is out here. Still, I think I could jump this gap to get across the canyon.
Ah, well, you're a regular Evel Knievel.
Oh yeah, you should see the jumpsuit I'm wearing.
Wow. They're getting, right into the conversation. I almost think, he's got something for her. Actually, it's probably the other way around. I haven't got any interest in her. I'm attached. And I'm hoping that we're going the right way, because I'm probably just climbing up this fucking mountain for no reason. But it looks like... It looks like the... The fire is at the top of this mountain, so I think we are going the right way. It's nice to talk to Deli. What? A turtle?
Whoa, I found a turtle. Maybe it's a tortoise? It's a thing with a shell.
Hey!
Isn't that something?
It's actually pretty cute.
Well, Henry, if you decide you want it to keep you company, nobody will mind.
Now, what do I call it? Looks like a,
Turt Reynolds.
That'll be good.
Bucket Jr. Since...
Turt Reynolds.
Well, now I can't wait to see him.
The mustache is impressive.
You tell him I love Cannonball Run.
Well, I was actually going for Ryan Reynolds... Because the whole Deadpool movie's out, but... I was going to call him Leonardo. Definitely adopting him. Now, how do you pull him out? Can you check your inventory? Where are we, actually? Righto, I know where we are, but where are we going to? I don't know! Oh. This is the supply cache that's near us. So... Where's that smoke gone? There we go. Just keep heading this way.
Just so you know, I didn't mean to overstep my bounds earlier when you brought up your wife.
I know you didn't. You were just making conversation. I appreciate it.
So, tell me about her, if you want.
She's a college professor. She's a PhD in biology, evolution, and stuff.
Ooh, evolution. That's a risque subject in these parts. Man, she sounds sexy.
She sure was.
Where does she teach?
Yale.
Yale?
Yep, the Yale.
Shit, Henry.
She flew back and forth. I hated it.
Yeah, I would too.
Yeah, anyway, that's her.
Cool story, bro. Yeah. I don't have the heart to tell her that. What? That she's sick. And her parents took her away. Okay, so we do have to go this way. Sweet, I'm on the right path. I had to trek from one end of the map to the fucking other. Although, it doesn't seem like there's a lot of paths to deviate from, so I don't know how long this story is actually going to be. But the way that they've done it is really quite well. I'm actually really impressed. I find, like, even the Walking Dead, it's a point and click. Was one of the best games that I ever played because of the story. Okay, where are we? What's in this? Hooray. Missing person, really?
How many hikers go missing in the Shoshone?
More than none, unfortunately, with most of them being in this area. The thoroughfare, because it's so remote. Why?
I found an old flyer for a missing hiker. It just got me thinking, that's all. Like how you said one day you were talking to the Goodwins, and then the next you weren't.
Ned Goodwin didn't get mauled by a bear or stuck in a ravine. He was just a PTSD'd a-hole who dragged his son out to do a job and realized it was a bad idea.
You really didn't like the guy, huh? PTSD doesn't sound good. Grizzlies won't kill a-holes.
PTSD? That doesn't sound good.
Yeah, I don't know. He was in the army. He was off. It's actually the saddest story. He was only discharged because his mother, Brian's grandmother, died. She'd been taking care of him, and Ned was the only next of kin.
Damn. And you got to know Brian a little bit?
Yeah. I talked to him way more than I'd talked to Ned, that's for sure.
How was he at, spotting fires?
Better than you. He actually liked to stay in the tower.
Oh, fuck you, bitch.
Well, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
You're so smart, Deli. How did you get so smart?
Found one of their empties. Guess we're on the right track.
Roger that.
Where are you putting all these beer cans? And unfortunately, all of them empty. They didn't save any.
You know,
for
if it makes
us.
You feel any better, you're a member of a diverse club of lookouts that have come to the thoroughfare after a breakup. There was Vernon, whose wife got put away for running cocaine. Becca, who was widowed after her husband, a jockey, was trampled by his horse. And Sharon, whose boyfriend had his own boyfriend. Maybe you boned the neighbor. Maybe she boned the neighbor. Maybe you both did.
We didn't break up. We didn't choose to break up. She got sick.
I'm sorry, Henry. What is it?
We'll get into it.
Okay. Well, in the meantime, you are here, and it's beautiful, and escaping isn't always something bad.
Yeah, sure.
There, I said it. I don't know if I'm ever gonna see her again, or even if she'll know me. When I see her again, where's that smoke? And are those birds circling around something? Check it out. Because usually, when there's birds, there's something dead. Well, that's my logic anyhow.
Hey, what's to the south of here?
Mexico? Is this some sort of riddle?
I just have a nice view to the south. You know, trees and mountains forever.
Eventually, you'll wander into the area overseen by Chimney Rock Lookout, but that's probably an impossible hike in terms of terrain.
Pretty sure. Okay, where are we going? North? North? This way. Looks like there's a campsite nearby. So hopefully those dumb bitches are there. And they're not mauled by a bear or something. Oh, I see a beer can. How much beer do they trek out of the woods? I must have to take a wheelbarrow. This one's full. Slenderman. He's a shifty one.
I see a campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
That seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down, and don't let them see you.
What a job this is. These girls have a full case of beer left here. A full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication. Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's the name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp. I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's another one of those magazines.
Damn it, I can't pick up the beer. Hello? Are you... Oh, that doesn't...
No, maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback.
At this stage, take whatever you want.
Tent looks like it's been through the shredder.
What could have done that? Like a bear, or,
Yes?
I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Whatever did it, did not hold back.
You've got that camera, right?
Some of their clothes are all torn up.
That's not good.
Looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
Okay, yeah.
Let me know what it says.
Just better take some evidence first. NCIS. Is that the show? I don't watch it. Okay, pick up note. Read note. Dear Psycho, hope you're fucking happy we're leaving and we're going to find the police or whatever and tell them how you creeped us out on the lake and then came and destroyed our campsite and all of our stuff. Oh, and stealing our panties is gross. Gross out. You're probably meant to fucking axe murderer, so we're going to jail. I hope it's worth being a jerk over some fireworks. Dick. They think I did it?
Oh, they're gone, for sure.
Well, what's it say?
Threatening to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
No way, I just stole their booze. I didn't do anything to them.
Henry, did you attack or do anything that could be perceived as an attack to these campers?
I didn't do anything to them, but it looks like someone had it out for them.
Then why do they think it's you?
Fuck, I don't know.
Huh.
Hey, I don't.
I believe you. Come on, Henry.
All right. It's just, it's weird what happened out here.
Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know. But they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back. And we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Day 3. I didn't even get to say about my sheets. Why are my sheets out here? Oh. Find boards downstairs to patch window. Look at that view. It's a view I could wake up to.
Hey, Henry?
Yeah?
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Superman.
I could be Tom Cruise's good-looking twin brother.
Oh, that's too bad. I read in People he's like 5'0".
Yeah, well, you can't win them all.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, PC, or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
Clothes? I don't really think about tuxedos and stuff.
Now this can't be that hard.
Clothes! I don't really think about it.
Oh, come on!
I got a sweatshirt I like. Good jacket I got at the Buckle Barn.
Ooh, I love the Buckle Barn.
Just one of those brown ones, you know?
I do. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
A man? I have a thick beard. My nose has been broken.
A pretty thick beard.
Oh, have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
All right. Perfect. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
Your what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
Steely.
They're steely. Cold, hard stare.
Like a Siberian husky.
Sure.
Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
Now, what do you look like? I want to know. It's, are you blonde, brunette? Do you have face whiskers?
I got that window all patched up. So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task and I'll give it to you.
Forrest. What the fuck, Forrest? You're laying around on the job. I'm not happy. You know what happened last time? Somebody broke in. That's because you weren't doing your job, okay? Now, get in the corner, and that's good enough. What the hell is this? This wasn't here before.
No. Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
How is that going to put out fires? A bucket of water.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
You know, it's not really that comfy. It's wooden and there's no padding.
I
actually got a splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aww. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
Loving my turtle.
Hello, Henry. Having a nice afternoon?
Yeah, great.
Not too bad. I could get used to it out here.
That's nice. Look, I called with bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
I'm happy to be questioned. I didn't do anything. It's probably a coincidence.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not going to be an issue. If they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
Yeah, don't. It's worth mentioning.
I think it's worth mentioning something.
I think it is worth mentioning.
Yeah. I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
Oh. Day 15?
Henry, wake up.
Miss, Deli, what's going on?
Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
Reynolds, what's going on?
What do you
Deli?
Want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
You're a big dumb idiot.
Oh, baby, you sound tired.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
Sure. Are you? Everything good there? Jules?
What? Oh, sorry, Henry. Yeah, I'm good.
Well, that's good.
Well, I'll let you get back to sleep
Jules?
Then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Sure.
Bye, baby.
Do we all sound like that? Day 33.
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway,
yes,
when
is.
You find a supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more. There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
That doesn't sound so bad.
So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night? You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation,
really?
And I'd just be spoiling it. Is there anything else you want to tell me about her?
I think I'm losing it. No, there isn't. I told you everything.
Yeah, actually. Look, I wasn't honest with you about her.
Well, why not?
Because I messed up. She got really early Alzheimer's and I lost her. She's still alive. She's being taken care of back in Australia because that's where she's from. She's there.
Oh my God, Henry.
And that's it.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Henry, listen. Oh my God, I'm so sorry you've gone through that. I don't know if you've thought of it this way, but her family is taking care of her, and you need to take care of you.
Thanks.
I'll let you keep hiking.
Well, I think we'll pause this video here. This video has gone long enough. Hope you've enjoyed watching. It's a very, very unique game, and I'm enjoying it. Anyhow, if you like this video, make sure you leave it a comment and pound that like button, and hope to see you in the next one. Till next time and space, take it easy. And as always, I salute you.